Hey, this is Rick from Hiking Emergency Beacon, and today I'm testing the Garmin inReach SE Plus right here. Same size as the Garmin Explorer Plus, but I'm going to test it out today and see how well it works. So before I do that, please like, subscribe, share, and turn on notifications so you'll be alerted as soon as I put out new videos. Well, we're going to get right to this today. I've already got it all set up, checked everything at home, made sure the maps, routes were there where they were supposed to be, contacts, all that. So I'm ready to go. So the very first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start tracking. Now I can do it on my phone or I can do it on a device. So I don't know. Let's just do it on the device for the fun of it. The reason I really like doing it on the device more than on my phone is because if you ever lose sync with your phone, battery on your phone goes dead, and whatever, if you can do this on your device, you're much better off. Okay, so what we're gonna do here, we are on a message right now. I'm gonna get out of it, and then we're gonna go to tracking. There is no tracking button on the sides or anything. There is the SOS, of course, right here. Important, most important thing ever. But you can go to tracking and set tracking from the menu. It's pretty easy to do. And then right here, it says start. So we're gonna start tracking. Let your friends know that your tracking description and link to your MapShare page will be included with this message. So now I'm going to hit share. I'm starting my route. Follow me on my trail. I am going to hit okay. Oh, it lets me actually do another message here. So it gives you a message that I created ahead of time. And it says, I'm starting my trip. Follow me. I'm okay with that. I'm going to go down to say done. Because you can like add more to it. Oh, so here's the deal where it says type recipients to where you want to, who you want to receive it. So you can arrow over to people, and I'm going to arrow down to myself. Yeah, so Richard, and that's me. I go by Rick, though. There's email, there's SMS. I'm going to do SMS and email. Let's just do that. All right, so now that's done. So now on the screen, it shows all the people that it shows myself, two different contacts that it's sending messages to. I'm going to take a picture of it so you'll be able to see it. So I'm going to send a message. I'm starting, there it goes. It's sending the message right now. So it's thinking and it's sending the message. So that's all good. Now, a couple other things real quick. Yep, sent the message already. That's good. Hopefully my wife will not be distracted and wondering if everything's okay. Well, I didn't send the message to her, though. I sent it to myself. All right. So what I found so far, if I look on the map on this, it doesn't show the map. When I was talking to Garmin before, I was talking about it, and they said that I was correct, that there's not downloaded maps. And here I am on the map page. It just shows an arrow where I'm at, but it doesn't show the map. Now, my phone is synced, and on my phone, it does show a map. So I don't know if I'm doing something wrong and it's not showing the map on here, but other than I believe Garmin's told me that it won't. I'm gonna talk to Garmin again just to make sure. Because right now, the way this is set up, the Explorer Plus is a little more powerful. It has this has the altimeter, barometer, accelerometer in it. This does not, as far as I've been told. It doesn't have the maps. But it's the same size you would think it would have the map. But you can see it on your phone if it's synced. I don't really see the reason for this device. But because the Garmin inReach Mini and Mini 2 came along, a third the size of this, at least half the size, and it does everything this one does, there's really no reason for this SE Plus. It's a little bit cheaper if you want to get it, or somebody offers it to you for not a whole lot of money, I would get it. Just don't really see the reason for it. And again, I think it might be discontinued. So just trying to give you real advice here to guide you on your decisions if you want to, if you're going to buy something. I do a lot of reviews on these messengers, so I wanted to have it anyway just to be able to talk about it and share things with all of you. So we've got the map here. I'm going to look on my phone real quick. And because of the sun, it's making it really dark. All right, like I said, you can see it on the map page here. It's actually very dark for some reason. Because, you know, when you have your phone in the sun, it makes it go, you know, you can set the brightness to auto, to bright. Probably need to change that. So I'm going to take some shots along the trail here. I'm going to do a short hike because I said, you know, there's just like 10 inches of snow dumped here. It's harder to hike right now without snowshoes. So I'm going to look at get some weather. I'm going to send a message. Of course, I've already sent messages, so you'll be able to see all that. I guess I won't send another message on this test. I'll just show you some screenshots. It works really well. It works perfect for people with the cell phone numbers, other satellite messengers, but you have to initiate it from the Garmin inReach devices first. So on this trail, I'll get some screenshots for you. I'll show you how it works, and we'll see if there's a track back function on this and if I can find my way back if lost. I know on the Mini 2, I can't confirm on the Explorer yet Plus because I haven't tried it, but I'm going to see about the track back on this, if it will bring me back to my location. I'll just do as thorough a test as I can, and you'll see screenshots up everywhere. I'll talk to you about it on the way, and then when I get back, we'll wrap it up. Okay, so I've just asked for a weather forecast, and I am going premium. That does cost $1 every time, even if you have the best subscription plan, which I do, still costs you $1. There is a basic weather that's free, and now I've just been notified of something. Let's see what that is. Got another notification. Things are just happening right here. So part of this is showing a waypoint and messages. There's location info. That's good. I'm wanting to see if the weather's showing up. So just a minute here, I'm going to actually start walking. Let's see if this shows what the all that noise was about. All right, so yeah, it's showing weather. So I'm gonna arrow over here to weather. Yeah, it says 1 minute ago. Weather, let's go ahead and select it. I kinda wanna see what it's like when you actually view it. Okay, so here it is on the phone. I'm gonna take a screenshot to this because it's different than what you would see on your device. I will tell you again, if you don't know, the weather is powered by dark sky. That's like four of the satellite messengers I've already checked. That's the way it is. So I'm gonna look at today here. I'm gonna select today, and now it's giving me hour by hour. I'm also gonna give you the screenshots here. So when you click on that, the hour by hour, it's giving me more information here. This is good. I hadn't even checked this before. So it's a clear 41 degrees, precipitation zero, light rain, no. It says light rain, but there's no percent of it. Cloud cover zero, wind south southwest 5 miles an hour, wind gust 8, pressure 30.06, wind chill is 38, humidity's 45, and it says powered by dark sky. So there you go. That's the weather on the device itself. Excellent. I love knowing how to use this device when you're not connected to your smartphone, because there's a lot of convenience when it's on a smartphone. But like this summer, we're going to be heading out on the Colorado Trail for 4 days, I believe, and I do have a battery backup. I believe I'll be able to use my phone. But I'll probably lose power on my phone if I use it too much. I'll probably have to get a better battery backup, or a couple of them. But it's really nice when you can just rely on the device itself. Well, let's look real quick at what it shows for the weather. It did show a red mark on the app. And now let's go see. Now here's the weather. Okay. It says 3 minutes ago. And it has, I'm going to put the screenshots up here. It has all the information. It's laid out probably the same information. It gives hour by hour. And then it gives the same information on humidity, winds, all that. It's just laid out a little bit easier to see here on the phone. All right, so next to check, we've checked weather. I've already checked messages. Messages, like I said, work awesome. Other than, make sure you, if you're with another satellite messenger, I'll repeat myself over and over on this. Make sure you initiate the messages from your Garmin if they don't have a Garmin inReach device. What's next? So I've already started tracking. It's going to be showing that I'm just sitting here not doing anything. So I got a share button here, a message from the Garmin. I can go on and look at the share map page. I will do that, like even right now. Why not? So if I were to send this to you, you were my friends, you would see this. I have to enter the password, and I don't know. I wrote the password down at home. I don't have it here. So when you share this, you can share, I think, without a password or with a password. I will take care of that back at the house, and I'll show you some screenshots of it. So you can see the screenshots right now, right over my shoulder, except I don't have the screenshot now. When I do the video editing, you'll see the screenshot. Powerful, powerful devices. Love these Garmins a lot. Hope you enjoy my dry sense of humor. All right, so let's get back to the map, and let's do a short hike again because the snow's pretty deep. We'll do a short hike, show the tracks being laid down. Anything else I think of on the way, I'll put them up and we'll talk about it. Finish up here at the end shortly. Okay, so I'm lost, but I have my Garmin inReach SE Plus. Not really lost. Just gonna fake it here. So I've been tracking. I'm gonna go turn tracking off, and it says stop tracking. All right, so I want to navigate back, and I know I can see where I'm at on my smartphone, on the app. But can I find my way back on the phone itself? And so what I want to do here is I'm gonna look real quick, because I don't see anything about navigating by track back. The Garmin inReach Mini and the Garmin inReach Mini 2 do have track back. Makes this really simple, and the Mini 2 automates it, so it's extremely easy to use, and you can see tracks on your screen without using a smartphone. So let me check into this a little bit, and I'm going to see about how I can navigate back if I actually were really lost without using my smartphone. All right, I've looked all over this Garmin inReach SE, and I can't find any track back, navigate by, track back. But as you can see right here, it does show my route on the screen. And I don't see a way to, say, have it follow it. If I move the satellite messenger around, then the arrow should point in that direction, that trail. So I have the ability to look at my smartphone and see on the map there, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna just see about following this back right here. I'm not super sure how well it's gonna work, but that's why I'm testing it. All right, so I've played around this a little bit. You can see, you can't see a whole lot of that trail. There were a few switchbacks. But if you hit that, there's a plus and minus right here on the screen. And if I arrow in on this, now you can see there's a switchback right here. I wouldn't call it a real switchback, but a curve in the trail. So I'm going to watch. I'm going to start hiking back here, even though it's not letting me navigate by track back. So it doesn't do as good of a job as a Garmin inReach Mini or Mini 2. Let's just see what it does. And when I turn and stuff, if that blue arrow right there, which is me, if it actually turns and follows me on the trail. All right, that arrow does move, and unless we follow myself on the trail, I can use these minus plus, zoom in and out on the trail, and helps me see where I'm going a little bit better. So let's just head back to my starting point, and then we'll wrap this up. So I didn't like how the map was displaying. So I went and checked on the settings in the map, and north arrow is up. I don't like doing that, so I'm going to click on that, go into heading up, and that should work a lot better. Let's go see what the map looks like now. Yeah, so the arrow is always going to stay up, heading in the direction, so that is the direction of the trail. If I were to turn around, yeah, I like that a lot better. So the map actually moved, and it's showing me where I'm pointing. So I always want to know,
you know, if I point this direction, but the trail is back the other way, I like seeing the map that way better. So that works good. All right, so I am hiking back and the snow starting to melt. And the heading is up. It's kind of hard to see that. But the trail is going to curve to the right here, which is true. So if you have the SE Plus, you will get home. It's just not as good as the Garmin inReach Mini, Mini 2, and Explorer Plus.
Okay, I'm back at the trailhead here, and I got back safe and sound. There is no track back on this, or navigating back to start by track back. Not like the Garmin inReach Mini, Mini 2, and I think the Explorer Plus. I gotta check on the Explorer Plus. But it's a good device. It reminds me of the Mini 2 in a way, where you can see your tracks and on the screen, but you and the routes, but you cannot see a topo map. So, you know, it's good in that regard. But the Mini 2 gives you alerts when you go off trail, visual and audible alerts. It's just a much smaller device and has everything and more that the SE Plus does. So really enjoyed using it. I think it's also discontinued. I'll put that up on the screen to verify if it is. So if you're looking to get into the market and this is available and it's really cheap, it's not cheap by the way, but if you can find it inexpensive, well, you know, sure, get it, go for it, because it has a lot of great great features, from two-way messaging to SOS, being able to see a route, syncing with your phone, all kinds of stuff. It is a good device. But if you're looking to get in the market and you want to buy one, go with the Mini 2 or the Explorer Plus. Absolutely, it's not even a choice. They're just a lot better models, and you know, for maybe $100, $150 more, but I would spend the money to get those other devices. So it's been a good field test, and I hope you enjoy it and learn something from it. And if you have any questions, man, leave them below. Ask me questions about these, because it helps me to get out here and research more and to do a better, more thorough job and help you to understand the device more. So please like, subscribe, share, and turn on notifications so you'll be alerted as I put out new videos. And thanks for joining me here, and I'll see you back in Colorado next time.